Dear students, first I would like to welcome all of you to Bhanga Virtual School. I hope that you are well by the grace of Almighty Creator. I am also well. At first I would like to give a special thanks to the authority of Bhanga Virtual School. They have created such a great opportunity for you to take part in class. Dear students, I hope that you are following your class routine, attending your class regularly and doing your homework. So let's start our class. Welcome to Bhanga Virtual School. You know my identification, I am Joydev Kumar Pal, assistant teacher, English, morning shift, Bhanga Govt Pilot High School, Bhanga, Faridpur. So dear students, this is our class for class 9 and 10, English second paper. Time will be 30 minutes and we are going to discuss a very important topics, suffix and prefix part 2. I have already taken a class on suffix and prefix. This is my second class, so I have written part 2. So I hope that you will be attentive in class and take your notebook and pen to attend class. Okay, dear students. So let's start our class on suffix prefix part 2. At first, I would like to introduce with the learning outcomes. I hope that after finishing the class, you will be, our students will be, especially you will be able to tell the definition of affix, prefix and suffix, tell the process of making new words, identify noun, especially I will discuss today identify noun and make noun, and I hope that after finishing the class you will be able to identify noun and make noun. Next, make new words from root word. So these learning outcomes is very important for you. I hope that you will be able to attend or develop your skills on this point. Okay, so get ready, dear students. This is the continuation of my class on suffix and prefix. So in the previous class I discussed about suffix, prefix and affix. Okay, I would like to remind you our discussed topics. I discussed on my previous class. Okay, so just attend. Affix, what is affix? Affix is a process. Affix is a process of making new words by adding prefix and suffix with the root word. Okay, so you can see a diagram, root word, prefix plus root word plus suffix. This process make new words. Okay, so I think that you can remember it. So we can go on next step. So homework review. I gave you homework to make new words as many as you can from this root word, imagine, employ, believe and succeed. Okay, so this was our homework. I hope that you have already done your homework. Now just check the answer check your answer with the words I am showing you. So what game make new words from the root word? Imagine, this is our homework. Okay, I am just giving the answer. You will check your answer with a notebook. Imagine is a root word. You can make many words from imagine. At first, imagination, imaginative, unimaginative, imaginary, imaginarily, imaginable, unimaginable, imagined, unimagined. Okay, so you can make such type of new words from a word, imagine. Okay, so there is another word, employ. Okay, employ, employment, employability, unemployment, employer, employee, employed, unemployed, employable, unemployable. Okay, you can make such type of new words from a word, employ. Okay, so match your answer. Next word, believe. I gave you a homework on believe. So you can make new words from believable, disbelieve, unbelievable, believer or believers. You can make a plural form, non-believer or non-believers, believability, belief. Okay, these are the words you can make from a word, believe. Next one, succeed. Succeed, you can make many words from word succeed: success, successful, unsuccessful, successfully, succeeding, unsuccessfully, succeeded, successfulness. You can make such type of words from a word succeed. Okay, so these are our homework. So dear students, now I would like to review our class on suffix and prefix. Affix is mainly two types. We have discussed already. Affix is mainly two types: prefix and suffix. So you know already what is prefix and what is suffix. Prefix and suffix is a letter or a group of letters which we add with the new root words and make new words. Okay, when we add this letter or group of letters with the to the front part of a word, it is called prefix. And when we add this letter or a group of letters with the ending part of the given word, it is called suffix. Okay, so prefix and suffix. We know that new words become only four types of parts of speech. Okay, though there are eight types of parts of speech, but these new words you are making, these new words become only four types of parts of speech. Okay, these parts of speech are noun, adjective, verb, and adverb. Noun, adjective, verb, and adverb. Okay, so always remember these four types of parts of speech. Next, the main discussion for today: parts of speech, identification of noun. So dear students, when you will find a word given in the bracket, you have to think about the place of the given word, because this place of given word will help you to understand what type of parts of speech you have to make with the new word. Okay, so in suffix and prefix, among noun, adjective, verb, and adverb, you will find a lot of nouns. So noun is very important for you. You have to at first identify the noun where you can find given word as noun. Okay, I will discuss now on the topic. So identification of noun. So you can identify noun when the given word you will find in the place of a subject of a sentence. Okay, as a subject of a sentence, that's mean you will find the given word in the place of subject of a sentence, it will be a noun. Okay, kindness is a great virtue. Kindness is a great virtue. Here kindness is the given word, and kindness is in the place of subject of this sentence. That is why this word kindness is noun. When you will find this given word in the place of subject, you have to form noun of the given word. Okay, kindness is a great virtue. Here kindness is subject of this sentence, and it is a noun of this sentence. Okay, next, as an object of a sentence, we can find noun as an object in the place of object of a sentence. Okay, when you will find this type of given words in the place of object, you have to form noun. Just follow. We must gain knowledge. We must gain what? We must gain knowledge. So knowledge here is in the place of object, and it is noun. Okay, we can find also virtue as a noun here in the first sentence. So as an object of a sentence. Next, after article, it is very important, because in suffix and prefix, in the most of the cases, we find article, adjective, noun. This is the formation of a part of a sentence: article, adjective, noun. But when there is no adjective, we find only article and noun, and it is very important, because you will find such type of pattern of a sentence in suffix and prefix. Okay, a lot of patterns like this. Follow. Happiness is the name of a feeling. Happiness is the name of a feeling. Here the article a and the feeling, it is a noun. Okay, and happiness is also noun here, because it is in the place of subject. So you will find noun after article. Okay, next, you can also find another example: he is a writer. Writer here is example. You will find like this: he is a write in the bracket, you have to write writer, because after article a, we will find this given word. Okay, So after article you will find noun, and it is very important. Next, after preposition, okay, you will find given word after preposition, you have to form the word noun. For example, many people buy books of different publications. Here of is preposition and the given word is in the place of after preposition. So you have to make noun of this word because this is in the place of after preposition. Okay, so you can find also this. And very important topics is after possessive case. After possessive case, possessive case what? My, our, your, his, her, their, its. Okay, these are all possessive case. So when you will get the given word after this possessive case, you will have to make this noun form of the given word. For example, we should take care of his satisfaction. Okay, so his possessive case, his possessive case, after possessive case, his satisfaction in noun is noun. Okay, so we should take care of his satisfaction. Next, we add ing with the verb after preposition. This rule is very important because after preposition we will find a lot of verbs, and when you will find verb after preposition, you have to add ing with this preposition, and this word adding with ing, this word will not be a verb, it will be a noun. Okay, so I am fond of playing. I am fond of playing. Here play is verb. I have added ing with the word play, playing. Here playing is object of preposition of. Okay, so when you will find verb after preposition, you have to add ing. The students, we use noun in the middle of the and of. We use noun in the middle of the and of, and in the middle place the and of, these words will be always noun. Okay, remember this. For example, we should realize the importance of tree. We should realize the importance of tree. Okay, the importance of trees. The and of, and in the place, in the middle, importance, it is noun. So this is the place by which you can identify noun. It is very important to understand the place of a noun. Okay, so I hope that this slide will help you very much. Next, formation of noun. We will now discuss about how can you make noun from the another word. Okay, so dear students, we know that nouns are mainly five types, but in the suffix and prefix only two types noun you will find in suffix and prefix. When you will make any new words, these new words will turn into only two types of nouns. These two types of nouns are common noun and abstract noun. Okay, common noun and abstract noun. So at first we will discuss about common noun. How can you make common noun from another noun, another words? You can, or we can make form common noun adding r e r o r double e I s t as suffix with the given word. Please remember r e r o r double e I s t as suffix with the given word. And most of the cases we make this common noun from verb. We make this common noun from verb. For example, drive, driver. Drive is verb, driver here is common noun. Teacher from teach, player from play, examiner from examine. Okay, these driver, teacher, player, examiner are all common noun, and this noun have been made from verb. For another example, visit, visitor, protector from protect, oppressor from oppress, inventor from invent. All these are verb, and these new words are common noun. Trainee from train, employee from employ, examinee from examine. These trainee, employee, examinee are common nouns. Supplier from supply, purifier from purify. ER, we have added ER, and in the place of Y we have added I. Okay. Dramatist from drama, scientist from science. So we have added here IST as suffix. Now, dear students, you can make many common nouns in such a way. From this structure, you can make many common nouns. Now, dear students, it is very important. Abstract noun, formation of noun. That's mean formation of abstract noun. You know, abstract noun is mainly formed from three sources. Okay, always remember, we can make abstract noun from three sources. Okay, what are the sources? The sources are common noun, adjective, and verb. We can make abstract noun from common noun. We can make abstract noun from adjective. We can make abstract noun from verb. Now we will discuss how can we form abstract noun from common noun. Okay. So dear students, you can use HOOD, DOM, SHIP, ISM, E or ARY, AGE, ITY or only TY, IAN as suffix to make abstract noun. For example, childhood from child, brotherhood from brother, motherhood from mother. So child, brother and mother are common nouns, and we have made childhood, brotherhood and motherhood this abstract noun from another common noun. Okay, so you can make abstract noun from common noun. There is another example: martyrdom from mitre, slavery from slave, librarian from library. So another example: friendship from friend, leadership from leader, scholarship from scholar. Heroism from hero, terrorism from terror, symbolism from symbol. Orphanage from orphan, hiatus from hire. So these are also all common noun, and we have just made abstract noun from the common noun adding this type of suffixes with the common noun. Okay. And there is another example: authority from author, personality from person. Formation of noun from adjective. We have already discussed about the formation of abstract noun from common noun. Now we are discussing the formation of abstract noun from adjective. How can you make abstract noun from adjective? Okay, please be attentive. You can use CE or CY, IT or ITE, NEWS, SHIP, ISM, E or ARY, HOOD, DOM, IST, TH, S suffix to make abstract noun. So you can use this type of suffixes to form abstract noun from adjective. For example, importance from important, independence from independent, urgency from urgent, happiness from happy, smoothness from smooth, idleness from idle. So here important, independent, urgent, happy, smooth, idle, all these are adjective, and we have made new words abstract noun from this adjective. Okay, importance from important, falsehood from false, freedom from free, wisdom from wise, bravery from brave, honesty from honest, ability from able, morality from moral. You can also add prefix to make opposite of this abstract noun, from ability, inability, morality, immorality, honesty, dishonesty. Okay, so you can make also opposite word by adding prefix. Okay, I will discuss about this on my next class. Naturalism from natural, fatalism from fatal, romanticism from romantic, truth from true. So these are about the examples of how can you make abstract noun from adjectives. Okay, so a lot of practice you need at your home to just be expert in suffix and prefix. So there is no option without practice at home. Formation of noun from verb. Now we will discuss how can you make abstract noun from verb. Okay, so there you will be find lot of rules on spelling. So dear students, you can use TION, ATION, SION or SSION, FICATION, MENT, ANCE, SIS, YESS as suffix to make abstract noun. Okay, for example, use of TION or ATION with the word ending with T, TE, ATE, D or DE, AC or ZE. So you can make, you can form abstract noun adding TION or ITION with the verb, this verb end with this such type of letters. Okay. For example, attraction from attract, collection from collect, this verb end with T, distribution from distribute, TE, invitation from invite, constitution from constitute, adulteration from adulterate, the verb ends with ATE, AT and E, and we have added ION omitting E, associate, association, association from associate, ATE. Attention or attendance from attend, pretension from pretend, degradation from degrade, civilization from civilize, memorization from memorize, urbanization from urbanize. Okay. So this is how you can make verb abstract noun from verb. Okay. So there is another rule. F-I-C-A-T-I-O-N with the verb ending with F-Y, the verb with ending with F-Y, you can make new words F-I-C-A-T-I-O-N, fication, beautify, beautification, identification from identify, glorification from glory, verification from verify. So you can, when you will find the verb ending with F-Y, just you have to add C-A-T-I-O-N to make noun. So another example. Use of SION or SSION with the verb ending with ISC, ET, IT or DE. Revision from revise, supervision from supervise, aversion from avert, diversion from divert. SS, here we add SION. Admission from admit, IT, the verb ends with IT, omission from omit, IT, permission from permit, IT, remission from remit, IT. Okay. Conclusion, conclude, decision, decide, reason, erude, intuition, intrude. And also use of Y with the verb ending with ISC or IJD. So when you will find the verb ending with ISC or IJD, just you have to add Y with this verb. From apology from apologize, agony from agonize, theory from theorize. Okay. And use of SIS with the verb ending with SE or JD, SE or ZE. For example, analysis, analyze, diagnosis, diagnose, emphasis, emphasize. Okay. SIJD or ISE, we have added SIS. These words are very important. Next one, use of ESS, the verb ending with double ED. For example, success from succeed, possess from proceed, excess from exceed. So these are the rules you can make abstract noun from verb. So there are another rules also. Formation of noun, abstract noun from verb, use of ANCE or ENCE, from maintain, maintenance, significance, signify, attendance, attend. Use of MENT, establishment, establish, attachment from attach, development from develop, improvement from improve, announcement from announce, judgment from judge, payment from pay. So you can also use MENT to make abstract noun from verb. Use of ing with the verb to make noun, from feeling, feel, walking from walk, swimming from swim. For example, swimming is a good exercise. We have added ing with the verb swimming, and this swim and this swimming, the word swimming here acts like a noun in this sentence. Swimming is a good exercise. Others, growth from grow, removal from remove, laughter from laugh. So this type of abstract noun you can make. So dear students, I hope that you have understood the formation of noun. I have discussed that you can make abstract noun. So this is how you can make abstract noun from the three sources: from common noun, from adjective, and from verb. So we can make many of abstract noun from verb. So I hope that this discuss will help you. So common noun, adjective, verb. We have already added, made new abstract noun from common noun, adjective and verb. So I will discuss about the formation of adjective, verb and adverb in my next class. Okay. So dear students, this is about your class work. You are just, you can see a passage given for you. You have to write the answer. As you are staying at your home, just you will write the answer of this given word. So you can see the given word is money cannot buy happy, happy, absolute, psychology, feel, content, satisfy, real, world, eternal, signify. So you will read the passage at your home and you will write the answer, okay, and then you will check the answer I will provide you. So okay, so I hope that you will write the answer at your home in your answer script. Now just match the answer with the this answer: happiness, absolutely, psychological, feeling, contentment, satisfaction, really, worldly, eternally, significance. Okay, these are your answers and you will just match the answer after doing the activities. Okay, so dear students, it is time for your evaluation. I hope that you will able to answer these questions. Dear students, now answer me, what is affix? Okay, what is suffix and what is prefix? Next, how can you make new words from a root word? Okay, you will give the answer. How many types of nouns do new words make or form? Okay, and what are these? How many types of nouns? How many types of nouns do make new words make? What are these? Yes, I hope that you will be able to answer the questions. Next, which source do you make abstract noun from? So from which sources you have made just abstract noun? Okay, I can help you from three sources. You have to tell the name of these three sources. Okay, yes. Next, I can go our next step. Identify the nouns from the following words. So these are the answer of your classwork activities and you have to just identify the nouns from this word. So identify the nouns from these words. Which words are noun? You have to identify this noun. Okay dear students, I hope that you will be able to answer all the questions. Now it is time for your homework. We are very ending part of our class. So dear students, this is all about your homework. Okay, so make new words as many as you can from the root words. You have to make new words as many as you can from these root words: beauty, develop, complete, satisfy. These are the four words and you have to write the words, new words, as many as you can. So dear students, that is all for today. I hope that all of you will attend the class on for more times. And I hope that you will do your homework. Okay, so thank you all.